Are you a spy?
No.
And we're going to do a safety demonstration. Now, we did this for the first show, and I think there's a couple, three of you here from that one. So you probably remember, but we're going to do it again. Many people think that blanks won't hurt you because they don't have that big chunk of lead out in the front. Well, that could not be further from the truth. And a few Hollywood types have accidentally killed themselves with blanks because they thought that they wouldn't hurt them because they didn't have a bullet. Well, guess what? We're going to take this aluminum can, the other one was this too, a Big K Diet Cola, and we're going to shoot it with a blank like the ones that we use. Who's doing that? Are you doing this one again? Well, you hit it last time. You must have been practicing. He'll test it on you. No. 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 All right, since this is the second show of the day, what we're going to do is we're going to take you back to Las Vegas, New Mexico, not Las Vegas, Nevada, where we, most of us anyway, go to visit our money on occasion, but Las Vegas, New Mexico, which was actually there first, and tell you a story about Doc Holliday when he was there. And then, after that, we're going to take you back again to 1880 and 1881, and we're going to show you what really happened in that vacant lot off Fremont Street near the OK Corral. But right now, we're going to take you back to Las Vegas in 1879. And it appears that everybody is just waiting with bated breath, right? Isn't that right? Yes, sir. All right. Places for Holliday in Las Vegas, please.
Wild West gave us many legendary figures. One of these was John Henry Holliday. Trained as a dentist, he was referred to by most simply as Doc. After contracting tuberculosis, he headed west in 1873, having been told the climate there would be better for his health. Although he practiced dentistry off and on until shortly before his death, Doc preferred the life of a gambler. He gambled in many frontier towns, including Fort Griffin and Dodge City in Kansas, Leadville in Colorado, and Tombstone, Arizona Territory, where along with the Earp brothers, he took part in the gunfight at the OK Corral. Even before that most famous of shootouts, Doc Holliday had seen plenty of action. He was thought to have been involved in more than 30 duels to the death. So step back with us now, back into history, and witness one of the first authenticated gunfights of John Henry Holliday. The year is 1879, 2 years before the gunfight in Tombstone. The place is the boom town of Las Vegas, New Mexico Territory. Doc is running a saloon he won part ownership of in a card game. Sally Jensen, one of the saloon girls, or soiled doves, is the mistress of Mike Gordon, an ex-Army scout and Indian fighter. Mike wants to take Sally away from her life in the saloon and tries once again to persuade her.
Sally, I want to talk to you. Move along, cowboy. This don't concern you. I said move along.
Mike, what are you doing here? I already told you. I don't want to go out to the frontier with you. Godforsaken land.
Well, I don't want you wearing that godforsaken hole no more.
I like my job at the saloon. What are you trying to do? Redeem a soiled dove?
Oh, hell, that's not it. I love you. I think you love me. I want to marry you.
Marry you? Where would you get that kind of money?
I got some money. Hell, maybe I'll take up cards like your boss, Doc Holliday.
But you're dreaming. Where are you going to get that kind of money?
What's this? Having trouble here, Sally?
Let's start cowboy, Doc.
Any day
to find yourself another girl there, cowboy.
Who made you owner of the street there, Holliday?
This is my street! My saloon! My women! And you are interfering in my business!
You ain't heard the last of my court.
Now you, get rid of
him! Are you satisfied I can lose my job over you?
Good! You lose your job, then you can go out with me!
You're pathetic.
I may be crazy, too, but if I'm crazy, it's because you made me that way.
Mike, go home!
I ain't done talking to you!
Bad for business.
Bad for business. Bad for business? I'll show you bad for business.
Mike Gordon realizes he has failed to get Sally away from her life at the saloon. Her rejection has only fanned the flames of his anger.
Bad for business.
He's shooting up the saloon.
Hey, you give me that gun before you kill somebody.
Yeah, maybe I'll start with you. Sally! Sally, I ain't done talking to you yet. Get out here. Sally! Sally! You're not gonna dodge me! Come out and keep yourself killed, Holliday!
I'll not be the one dying today, sir.
Gordon, Doc Holliday thought it best to move on. He survived many more gunfights, including the Earp Clanton feud in Tombstone.
Sir,
what gunmen had failed to do, disease finally accomplished. In 1887, John Henry Holliday, dentist, gunfighter, and gambler, died in bed of tuberculosis at the age of 35. He is buried where he died, in Glenwood Springs, Colorado.
Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to take you back to 1880, 1881, and we're going to show you what really happened in that vacant lot off Fremont Street, because the gunfight at the OK Corral did not happen at the OK Corral. It happened in a vacant lot off of Fremont Street with the Harwood House on one side and Fly's boarding house and photo gallery on the other side. But it was near the OK Corral. And how many people do you know that would go see a movie called Gunfight in the Vacant Lot next to the Harwood House? It just doesn't have the same ring to it. And so now we're going to take you there.
The gold rush of the late 1800s brought a multitude of people to the western United States. One of these was Ed Shefflin, prospector, who in the summer of 1877 was told by soldiers from Camp Huachuca that all he would find out there would be his tombstone. In a way, they were right. Ed Shefflin struck silver. His mine and the thriving, raucous boom town that grew up around it were to be known as Tombstone. The most eventful period from late 1879 until mid-1882 was marked by the arrival and departure of Wyatt Earp, his friends, and family. By mid to late 1880, the lines were drawn, with the cowboys, or outlaw elements, on one side, and the Earps and their supporters on the other. The reasons for friction between the cowboys and the Earps were many. A stage holdup that ended with the killing of the driver, accusations of wrongdoing by each side against the other, flagrant violations of city ordinance by the cowboys, and on October the 26th, 1881, an arrest gone bad that culminated in the most famous face-to-face gunfight in American history, the gunfight at the OK Corral. And now, allow me to introduce the cast of characters who take part in the impending drama, the Reverend Mr. McIntyre, Marshal Fred White, John Behan, sheriff of Cochise County. William, better known as Curly Bill, Brocious. Friends on both sides joined in that day. With the Cowboys were Billy Claiborne, Frank McLaury, his brother Tom McLaury.
Tom, you sell those cattle like I told you to?
The Clantons were represented by young Billy Clanton, and the leader of the Clanton-McLaury faction in Tombstone, Joseph Isaac Clanton, known to all as Ike. Among Tombstone's other citizens was medical examiner and physician, Dr. George Goodfellow. Also in Tombstone were the ever-present drifters, ranchers, and miners. Perhaps most important to those miners and trail hands were the bartender and shady ladies. Next is John Henry Holliday, better known as Doc. Dentist, gambler, friend of the Earps, cold-blooded killer. Mayor of Tombstone and editor of the Epitaph, John Clum. And the Earps themselves, Morgan Earp, Town Marshal of Tombstone, Virgil Earp.
Morgan, you seen Wyatt?
Down in the Oriental.
Have you seen him by his promise yet?
Well, and perhaps the best known of the Earp brothers, Wyatt Earp.
One day in 1881, the Tombstone Epitaph, a booming newspaper in a booming silver mining town, screamed out the headlines about a gunfight at the OK Corral, right downtown. The headlines read, "Murder in the streets of Tombstone." Well, that wasn't such hot news, but more stark and spine-chilling than that was a sight on the boardwalk in front of the Epitaph building. Neatly laid out in beautiful caskets were the bodies of Tom McLaury, Frank McLaury, and young Billy Clanton. Today there's no more silver mining in Tombstone, but up there on Boot Hill, you can see where the graves of the men are. The ones who fought over or because of a big silver strike that created Tombstone. Out in Arizona, just south of Tucson, where tumbleweeds tumble in search of a home, there's a town they call Tombstone, where the brave never cry. They live by a six-gun, by a six-gun they die. It's been a long time now since the town was a boom. The jailhouse is empty, so's the palace saloon. Just one look will tell you that this town was real. A secluded old dirt road leads up to Boot Hill. Walk up to the fence there and look at the view. That's where they were hanged. It's easy to see where the
child.
We need you back in the ranch.
We need you.
It gets my lonesome. Looking down over
the tree.
Go
back to Ike, what are you doing?
There lies Billy Clanton.
This is over.
Way up on Boone
Hill. Leave this be. My brother's in the ground. I know that. Leave it be. It's over. It's not over till I say it's over. I ain't telling you.
The gunfight is history. The funerals are over. Return with us now to October 27, 1880, a year before the gunfight, and witness what was to become the first in a series of events which would lead up to the most famous face-to-face gunfight of all time at the OK Corral. Wyatt Earp, returning home from Tucson, sees Curly Bill, Ike Clanton, and the rest of their bunch in the saloon and sees that they are all wearing guns.
Oh, no.
There's Marshal White talking to Wyatt.
Fred,
be careful.
Get away from that loud old Fred. Get over here.
In this part of Arizona territory, the three things feared most are the strike of the rattler, the sting of the scorpion, and those San Pedro cowboys.
You guys think you can shoot? I know I can shoot. Fill her up there! I got it four times.
Put the guns away, you know there's no
shooting. Oh, Fred, quit.
What's the matter with you?
Accident, and Virgil Earp is appointed to fill his position for the balance of the unexpired term. With Virgil Earp as Marshal, things will change, and the Cowboys know it. Marshal White had no real backing, and the outlaw element did pretty much as they pleased. No, the appointment of Virgil Earp is not popular with the Cowboys.
You left the rest of the law.
Look, I'm sworn to uphold the law same as you.
I don't tell you to stay out of my jurisdiction, so you stay out of my way.
Virgil, let him go.
Politician!
Almost a year later, on the night of October 25th, 1881, just hours before the gunfight, Ike Clanton is in town headed toward the Alhambra Saloon.
Ike! Have you seen Billy?
Billy's out doing chores. He went back.
Well, I need another horse. I just had to put mine down.
He's not doing that.
Doc Holliday's looking for you. He's gunning for you.
I'm not afraid of that.
You ain't gonna be afraid to get killed. That man will kill you if you don't watch your back.
Scare
get that to your face, he will kill you.
You're an old woman.
What? Where are you hiding? There you are, you miserable coward.
Coward?
Where's the baby in there?
That's enough. I'll
put a stop to it right now.
A dusty two-bit livery stable perched on the outskirts of the Arizona town of Tombstone. A spot halfway on the way to oblivion, until suddenly, violently, history stepped in and changed its course forever. In less than half a minute on a cold October afternoon, the OK Corral passed into the legend, the myth, the tragedy of the old West. 34 shots were fired on that 26th day of October 1881. The date is October 26, 1881. The place is Tombstone.
Arizona territory. Please, this is Quam, John Quam, Mayor of Tombstone speaking. Word is sent to me that Ike Clanton is in the city of Tombstone, brandishing a weapon. Do not attempt to disarm him yourself, but report his whereabouts immediately to Town Marshal Virgil Earp.
I'm calling Ollie out! And bring that lunger with you!
He's looking for the Earp.
Take care of him, too!
There's Virgil. Brother Morgan.
What'd you do that for? Get up!
They stiff armed Ike Clanton. Here comes Wyatt.
Get up here. Get up here.
Come on. Come on. You're going to jail.
Jail.
Article 9. Looks bad. Real bad. Clanton's got friends in Tombstone, and they won't stand for much of
this. This is about you. I'm going to get in there.
Get it. Careful what you ask for, Clanton.
I'll get you.
Tom McLaury. He's calling out to Wyatt.
Light up!
Turn on a face for you. Listen. What do you want, McLaury?
Two things. One, you're going to answer. What kind of knife? Two, is this gun on the gun?
Order the guys passed. No more carry of firearms.
This won't be any problem.
By my authority.
Wyatt Earp handled the likes of his kind.
That makes out the law.
Is that so?
How many boys are going to have to bleed before you get it through your head? Are you healed?
Good.
And it's done. Pistol whip them and leave them lying in the street as a harsh warning to others.
Somebody get this trash off the street.
Hey, come on. Let's get you.
I came as quick as I could.
It's 2 o'clock.
All right, get out of here.
Tombstone, Arizona is quiet today.
What?
Cold. Cold and a little windy.
Where have you been?
There's a fight building.
I told you, you don't call Wyatt Earp out.
Last night, Doc Holliday told Ike Clanton to kill him. Well, today, he carried out steps to be killing. Virgil arrested Ike about 2 hours ago. But Ike paid his fine and he's out of jail.
No, don't worry about what I did. What did you do?
Look there. Sheriff Ian talking to Frank McLaury on Fremont Street. And there's his brother Tom McLaury.
Look at us! Look at his head!
William Claiborne.
Listen,
Billy Clanton. And there he is.
Listen,
Ike Clanton himself. Three, five, and it looks like they're armed.
I didn't call him out.
Yeah, you did.
I was minding my own damn business. You had no
sign.
I did know that.
What the hell's going on here?
You're waiting. Just waiting for some sign of the earth. And no one comes.
Maybe
the earth party won't show at all. Clanton's got friends in town, but the earth got the
earth committee
backing them.
You got to keep this boy under control. I need to get a hold of the governor.
There they are.
Change that argument.
It's them, all right.
If you know,
there's Virgil Earp, the marshal.
We're going to have the army down here.
Experience.
Hey, no, you don't want
on the right.
There's something.
Brother Morgan on the left.
We need to do something
with
them.
Today.
I'll take care of the earth. You keep them
Doc
under control.
Holiday.
Good. You're awful.
Do something.
Out. That's all you're good at. Do it.
What do we pay you for?
Yeah.
Listen, I take care of county. You know that. That's my job. You keep
Sheriff
them under control.
You're going to talk to the marshal.
Keep my son.
Man. Here, you got a gun.
Virgil,
why didn't you get your
gun? They're going down there. They're putting up their guns. They're leaving town.
They're carrying their weapons.
They're in my family.
I'm tired of it.
Listen, they're leaving town. Leave them be.
I won't leave them be. This is a town matter. Breaking the law. Get out of here.
20 feet. My God, how far are they going to go? 10 feet.
Raise your hands and we're going to find you.
Oh, I don't want that!
It ain't gonna...
Oh,
that shouldn't
be
there! Oh,
I
killed
him! More cartridges!
No!
Doc, help Virgil.
I didn't want this to happen!
Where you at, Morgan?
Through the shoulder.
I've got your...
Quiet!
happened?
You're not careful, Johnny.
25 seconds and 30 minutes past the hour of 2 on a cold October afternoon in Tombstone, Arizona. Three men are wounded and three dying. And Ike Clanton has run from a fight he's wanted for so long. And you've seen it. You've seen the gunfight at the OK Corral as it actually happened. October 26, 1881, Tombstone, Arizona Territory, and the Arizona gunfighters have taken it there.
Take a bow, gang.
Thanks for coming! Thank you very much. Come back to see us again.
We will be back here on May 11th.